If you sit down and watch the evening news, I think you pretty quickly come to the conclusion that the world's a bit of a mess. I don't know anyone who would say, hey, the world's in great shape, it's moving in a great direction, we just got to keep it moving in the direction it's going. I think if you ask your parents, you'll discover they're a bit concerned about the world that you'll grow up in. I think if you ask your grandparents, you'll probably discover they try not to think about what sort of world you'll grow up in because it just makes them too anxious. You see, they've seen enough of the change to recognize just how disturbing the trends are. So how did the world get to be a bit of a mess? Well, do you want the truth, or do you want some sugar-coated answer? Lots of people could give you, lots of different reasons and answers and excuses, but most of them would focus on one aspect of the mess. They will talk about suffering and death, or the collapse of the family, or poverty and economic turmoil and environmental breakdown. But these are all just symptoms. What's the disease? I mean, if you get the flu, your symptoms may be a sore throat, a hacking cough, a fever, a runny nose, and aches and pains. But the only way to fix the symptoms is to treat the disease. Suffering and death, the collapse of the family, poverty and economic turmoil, environmental breakdown, and whatever else you want to add to the list, these are all just symptoms. But let's get back to the question. How did the world get to be a bit of a mess? The big answer to the question, the macro answer, is that people are sinful and they turn their backs on God. Sin is the disease. And the truth is, sin makes us unhappy. God never intended us to suffer and die. His original plan, his original idea, was for us to live in paradise forever. God's original plan was for ever-reigning peace between God, man, and the environment, and harmony between all men and women. Suffering and death are a direct result of sin. In session two, we talked about Gideon from the book of Judges. This whole book of the Bible is a series of stories that illustrate the Israelites turning away from God and then turning back to God. They do it time and time again. They turn away from God and then they turn back to God. Each time they embrace sin and turn away from God, their lives became miserable. Each time they turned their backs on God, they fell into another form of slavery, just like when they were in Egypt. You see, sin always leads to slavery of one kind or another. The same thing happens to us. When we turn away from God, our lives become miserable. Sure, there may be pleasure to be had in the moment, but the pleasure is fleeting. It's not sustainable. And after the pleasure of sin has faded, there's just the misery it inevitably leaves behind. And every sin makes the world a little bit more of a mess. You see, sin and evil are real. Sin and evil are real. And they are not just something that's out there. They're in you and me. We each have the capacity for tremendous good, tremendous virtue. But we also have the capacity for sin and evil. These things are in us. And we have to come to terms with that. If we're really going to live the life that God wants us to live, if we're really going to live life to the fullest, we got to also come to terms with the fact that we're capable of sin. So what is sin? Well, sin is usually spoken about as a behavior that is wrong or immoral. And it is, no question, it's that. But the only way to truly understand sin is in the context of the relationship between God and humanity. If you really want to understand sin, you got to understand what sin does to our relationship with God. You see, God is infinitely good, and all his works are good. It is out of his goodness that God created us in his own image and for good. You see, God created you for good. Sin is more than just bad behavior. It is the rejection or destruction of something really, really good. You cannot reject or destroy something that's good without rejecting goodness itself. And God is goodness. And so every sin is in some way a rejection of God. This is why the most devastating dimension of sin is separation from God. When we sin, we put an obstacle between ourselves and God. You see, sin breaks down our relationship with God. It puts obstacles between us and Him. We have a long history of that. Humanity has a long history of turning away from God, offending God, rejecting His goodness. And this is where Jesus enters the story. The central claims of Christianity are that God became man in Jesus, that he died on the cross to atone for our sins, and that he rose from the dead to liberate us from death. But Jesus also came to show us the best way to live. Nobody can teach you more about the best way to live than Jesus. Try this. Read the Gospel of Matthew. As you read about what Jesus taught, ask yourself, are these the solutions to the mess the world is in today? I think you discover they are. I think you'll discover that Jesus has the antidote to the world's mess. You see, Jesus is the solution. What does this mean for you and me? Well, it's easy to say, oh, the world's a bit of a mess. But the thing is, the more I become aware of who I really am, the more I discover I'm a bit of a mess too. I do things every day that don't help me become the best version of myself. And most of the time, I don't actually want to do these things. Just like Paul wrote, I do not do the good I want, but the evil I do not want is what I do. I am capable of incredible good, but sometimes I turn my back on God and His goodness. Sometimes I do it because I'm stubborn, and other times because I'm lazy. Sometimes I turn my back on God and His goodness because the right path just seems too hard. And other times, because I'm selfish and I just want what I want. The truth is, I'm a sinner, and sinners need a savior. Yeah, the world's a bit of a mess, and I'm a bit of a mess too. But Jesus came to fix the mess, and that's good news.